Well, scientists say there is new proof of the genius of Albert Einstein. They say a prediction he made 100 years ago as part of his general theory of relativity is accurate when it comes to so-called gravitational waves in space. A group that has been looking for them at a special observatory says their devices picked up the waves in September of last year. Gravitational waves are created by massive forces like orbiting or colliding black holes. Because the waves pass straight through matter without changing it, they could open up a whole new area of astronomy, giving us a clearer picture of black holes and other unseen parts of our universe. My next guest was one of the leaders in this discovery, joins me now to discuss what it all means, and we're talking about Laura Cadonati, who is a professor at the Georgia Institute of Technology's School of Physics. Professor, terrific to have you on. What you and the others have achieved is both extraordinary and, for most of us mere mortals, impenetrable. What is the simple person's explanation for what this discovery means?
Well, what this discovery means is two things. So on one end, we have now found the missing piece in Einstein's theory of general relativity. So we now know he was really right all the way through the end. We also know that we now have a new way to explore the universe around us. Gravitational waves are going to be a new probe, are going to give us new information on some of the most mysterious objects in the universe, such as black holes. And once we combine what gravitational waves are telling us together with what we know from electromagnetic observation, we're gonna have a more complete picture of the universe around us. So that's starting from the black holes all the way out to the Big Bang.
That's extraordinary, really it is. But how do you use then the gravitational waves? How do you put them to use to do that sort of research and exploration?
So, well, for instance, we didn't know for sure that there were black holes that are the size, 30 to 40 times the size of the sun. Now we do know that those objects exist. We know that they form pairs and they merge. And so this is information that we didn't have at all. Looking ahead, if there were to be, say, a supernova in the galaxy, then we could know what's happening inside the supernova, because gravitational waves are very different information from electromagnetic waves. And so they tell us what's happening inside these very dense objects, such as black holes and neutron stars. Mm. So to make an analogy, we can hear sound, we can see lights, we combine the two sets of information, and we have our perception of reality. So we're gonna do something similar. We're gonna have the gravitational waves, we're gonna have electromagnetic waves, and a better perception or better understanding of the universe around us.
So what's extraordinary about this is, I mean, obviously you've achieved this, you've shown that Einstein was right, but perhaps what's more extraordinary is that he came to this conclusion 100 years ago, and he didn't have any of the fancy toys that you guys have. What does that tell us about him?
That he was a real genius. he had this unbelievable imagination, I guess, this ability to imagine what is at the underlying explanation of reality around us. And he has made many, many important predictions. He has redesigned the way gravity is. So he has brought us a whole new perspective. And 100 years later, we have been able to prove the final missing piece of the theory. So it's the whole thing is just amazing. He could have that vision. And then 1,000 people have been working to bring it all to realization. So that's a major progress for humanity as a whole.
One final question. Do you think everyone else in the world who was hoping for a Nobel Prize in physics can now just go home?
Well, I guess I cannot talk for what the Nobel Committee will have to say, but we are really rooting for a Nobel Prize in gravitational waves this year. But yeah.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say you've got a really good shot. Laura Cardinati, thank you so much. I appreciate it, Professor.
Thank you.